As we are knowing that the rainwater harvesting is quite common terms, even perceived by the rural people nowadays, and it is the need of the hour to adopt the rainwater harvesting at the mass scale, because there are two aspects of this water resource. That is, one is quantity and second is the quality. If quantity is not available of the water resource, we cannot think about the quality. So to make the water resource sustainable for the future generation, it is very urgently required to implement the rainwater harvesting at mass level and to transfer the technology of the rainwater harvesting or techniques of the rainwater harvesting to the rural areas also. So therefore, I have selected this topic to be discussed so that it does not convey the significance only the academic but also the social. So the society also needs the implementation of the rainwater harvesting structures, and how efficiently and how feasible structures can be constructed in different parts of the country. Here I am trying to explain that. And before attempting the different type of techniques under the rainwater harvesting, what are the different parameters to be known, that is also going to be discussed. But before coming to the main area of the techniques of the rainwater harvesting, I would like to emphasize one fact, that the people should be given this technology or the techniques so that they can efficiently apply it at their own residence, own house, so that the objective of this rainwater harvesting is not forfeited. So let us start or discuss the techniques of the rainwater harvesting one by one. We have here decided to discuss these techniques of the rainwater harvesting in two parts. Certain techniques are quite useful and feasible for the rural areas. Those techniques cannot be replicated for the urban areas. So I have here tried to differentiate those techniques for rural as well as urban areas to be discussed. If any project or the technique we implement on the ground, people certainly ask, what is the need of this project or technique? So first we should emphasize and justify rather, what is the need of this rainwater harvesting. First is, it will arrest the declining trend of the groundwater. Second, we need the pre-monsoon and post-monsoon the groundwater level. Third is the drought prone areas, and then quality affected areas are the quality, groundwater quality problematic areas. So the rainwater harvesting is not going to cover only the quantity, but apart from the quantity, it will also cover or it will also look the groundwater quality problem. So therefore, we should explore the area which is characterized by the declining trend of the groundwater level, and the magnitude of the declining trend, if it is beyond 25 centimeter per year, that area is prioritized, that is on the top priority. So because we are having the limited financial assistance either from the government or from the public, therefore we must scientifically prioritize the areas for the rainwater harvesting. Therefore we must have the knowledge, have the figure, have the data of the groundwater level both during pre-monsoon and post-monsoon period. If suppose that there is no quantitative deterioration, there is no quantitative depletion, even the groundwater quality, if it is deteriorated, certainly we may think to attempt the rainwater harvesting structures through the different type of techniques. If the need is justified for the rainwater harvesting, the second point is which type of water is available to recharge the groundwater under the rainwater harvesting. So there are major two sources of the water. One is the rainwater, as the name of the topic is rainwater harvesting. That same term is reflected here because the rainwater is one of the purest form of the water except first spell of the rain. So therefore, it is the boon for our country during 4 months period of the monsoon that we must try to arrest all the runoff during these 4 months period. And then quality of the water is also very important, which is going to be recharged through this rainwater harvesting. If suppose that we are recharging any aquifer for sustaining its water level, and if you are pouring down the bad quality or the poor quality of the water, it is going to deteriorate the quality of the aquifer, which is very harmful for future generation and for human health. So therefore, it is very, very important and urgent to know the quality of the water which is going to be recharged under the rainwater harvesting. So source is one thing, major source is rainwater, but apart from the certain pond water, certain canal, excess canal water at the tail end, if it is there available, then we can also think about to recharge that water, surplus water, under the rainwater harvesting system. The third is the quantification, because if we are thinking to adopt and implement the rainwater harvesting system in our country and in the area or domain of the high urbanization and the, you can say, the metropolitan cities, we are knowing that the land is very limited and very costly. So we cannot blindly select any technique. Therefore, we must quantify the runoff so that the design of the any rainwater harvesting system is optimum and it is efficient. So quantification is also important, and how we can move for quantifying the total runoff available from the rooftop or any catchment area during the monsoon season or during the rainy season. So we need the catchment area, we need the average annual rainfall, we need particularly the intensity of the rainfall. Why intensity of the rainfall is needed? Because we cannot design the perfect structure without having the component of the intensity of the rainfall per hour. Annual rainfall is significant to understand how much runoff will be generated from any catchment area, but until and unless we are having the hourly rainfall data or the intensity of the rainfall, we cannot have the proper design of any rainwater harvesting structure. Therefore, the rainfall runoff coefficient we apply for the quantification, a simple formula is that catchment area multiplied by the rainfall runoff and multiplied by the rainfall runoff coefficient. So therefore, we need the rainfall runoff intensity. Rainfall runoff coefficient is fixed. It is 0.80 for the paved area. It is 0.50 for the open area, open land, and it is 0.45 is the for green area or the forest area. So it is fixed and unitless, because we know that the coefficient has no unit. So therefore, the simple formula to quantify the runoff is area multiplied by the rainfall intensity per hour, then multiplied by the rainfall runoff coefficient. We get the total runoff. So if we are quantifying the total runoff, after that, it is a big question that whether this surplus runoff will be recharged below the ground at that particular place where we are thinking to design that structures, utilizing that technique or not. Otherwise, entire exercise will be futile if we are not taking the cognizance of this fact that scope is there to recharge that groundwater. So how we can justify, how we can verify that yes, there is scope for the groundwater recharge? We take the help of the groundwater level and its flow map, contour map. Then second is long-term seasonal water level fluctuation, we use it. And then third is the subsurface lithological behavior. What is the subsurface lithological behavior? Because we are getting the soil profile changed from place to place. It is even in the alluvial area where we are sitting in Varanasi or Allahabad or Kanpur or any part of the Indo-Gangetic plain. Even we feel that the Soil is homogeneous. It is totally alluvial area, but even we move 500 meters apart from one point to another point, we find the difference in the soil profile. And if you find the change in the soil profile, certainly its permeability is different, intake will be different, and the lateral flow of that recharged water from one place to another place will be different. The velocity of the groundwater will be different. So therefore, we must have the strata chart or lithological chart of that area, and we can get from the simple hand pump. There are several hand pumps installed in any area, and we get the strata chart or lithological chart from that hand pumps, and we get the knowledge, or you can say the information, that at what depth permeable granular soil is existing. So that is quite helpful to understand the scope for groundwater recharge. If all these three parameters are justified and it clear, then we move forward or move ahead to adopt the techniques of the rainwater harvesting and different type of rainwater harvesting techniques to be implemented at different places. As I mentioned earlier also, that what are prerequisites: depth to water, water level fluctuation. Why water level fluctuation is important? Because this point I did not discuss in the earlier slide. So water level fluctuation is very important to be known, because the water level fluctuation reflects that what is the zone after recovery from the pre-monsoon to the post-monsoon in the aquifer. And if natural recovery is very fast, then the scope of recharge is limited. If the natural recovery is less, or it is not so fast, not rapid, then certainly the scope of the rainwater harvesting or artificial rainwater harvesting is more suitable and required. And subsurface lithological behavior, I have discussed already. Rainfall pattern and intensity, we have already discussed that. Why the rainfall pattern and intensity is required? Intensity is different than pattern, because rainfall pattern, why it is important? Because we can apply and we can select the particular area where the rainwater harvesting is prioritized. As we are knowing the fact that there is a concept of the climate change, and we are finding that conclusion after the IPCC report that rainfall pattern will change in the future, and the area which is under drought condition today, it will come under the flood situation. So if this is the situation, certainly we must have the rainfall pattern so that therefore we can prioritize and identify the area for future under the rainwater harvesting system. Then I take up the first technique, very simple method, rooftop rainwater harvesting. It is very useful for the urban areas, for any city areas, because we know that land is very limited, and all the areas under the any urban area or city have been concretized either by the construction of the building or by the roads. Therefore, the natural recharge has been reduced. To increase that recharge rate, we must adopt the rooftop rainwater harvesting in the urban areas. The diagram reflects that it is a very simple roof, means the house, connected with the filter chamber. After connecting all the rainwater pipe, it is connected with the filter chamber, and the filter is nothing but it is composed of the gravel, pebble and sand, which is known as natural filter. And then it is simply, here we have mentioned the dugwell recharge, or you can say the open well recharge. Simple, if the abundant open wells are there, we can pour down this runoff, and certainly the groundwater will be recharged here without putting much cost. Here we are finding in the diagram, it is very simple structure. It can be maintained very easily. There is no complex engineering design in this method. So it is very important to look that no abandoned well goes as unarrested. It should be utilized as the recharge well. Then what I discussed in the previous slide, that about the filter. Here it is very clear on the bottom about the structure of the filter. The bottommost bed is characterized by the pebbles, then followed by the gravel, then followed by the coarse sand. And as I mentioned in the beginning, that the first spill of the rainwater is contaminated. So if you see on the top of the diagram right side, flow diverter is there. The use of the flow diverter is to arrest the runoff generated from the rainfall, and then in the first spell it can be regulated to flow outside in the normal drain. There is a flow diverter, so if you are having the first spell of the rain which is contaminated, then it should be thrown out through the normal drain, and rest of the rainfall occur during the monsoon period should be diverted through this filter. So here my emphasis is what is the structure of the filter and how the filter is designed. Then the urban areas of under the rooftop rainwater harvesting, the third component is the recharge well. As I mentioned that due to the paucity of the land, and land is very costly in the urban area, we should design such efficient recharge well and structure, rooftop rainwater harvesting structure, which does not disturb the people, number one. Number two, it does not consume or it does not cover much area of land in the city. Then third is the upkeep or maintenance is very simple. So therefore, here I am going to explain through the diagram that what is the concept of recharge well and how it is constructed. If we are constructing the recharge well, we must assess the intake capacity of the recharge well, because if you are not understanding, or rather you are assessing the intake capacity of the recharge well, you cannot design the recharge tank properly. So therefore, we must have the assessment of the intake capacity of recharge well. So before coming to the diagram or the technique of the recharge well construction, I am just emphasizing how we can perform the intake capacity of the recharge well. There are two methods. One is crude and one is the very correct, or you can say the optimum method. First is slug, which is very optimum, or you can say the defined method that is implemented in hard rock area. While in the soft rock area, because we are knowing the heavy discharge or the high discharge of the aquifer is there in the soft rock area, in the alluvial area, therefore here we are taking the help of the fixed quantity of the water in the tanker, and keeping the water level, static water level constant of the well, we pour down the fixed amount of or quantity of the water, and we record the time, in how much time the entire amount of water is absorbed by the particular aquifer which has been tapped by the recharge. So that is the intake capacity. And how we can have the idea that static water level is constant by using the water level sounder. This is the water level sounder. Here we are using this water level sounder inside the well, recharge well, and when the water level is touched to that sounder, we get the sound, beep sound, and when the water level goes down, it does not touch the sounder, the sound is off. So therefore, our aim is to maintain or keep the water level constant, static water level constant. Therefore, this instrument, water level sounder, is applied during the performance, or during the testing rather, of the intake capacity. Now, how we can design the recharge or the storage tank? If we construct the recharge well, we find the intake capacity of the recharge well, and then we know how much water, surplus water, is still remain to be stored, which is not going to be absorbed by the aquifer. Therefore, volume of the recharge or storage tank is calculated. I have here cited one example of a roof area which is taken into the consideration, and if I take the volume of the water is around 61 cubic meter per hour, and intake capacity of one recharge well, as tested earlier, I have already explained about the testing method, it is 5 cubic meter per hour. So if suppose it is very simple, that if it is the total volume of the runoff is 61 cubic meter per hour, and intake capacity of the one recharge well is 5 cubic meter per hour, the space required for the storage of that remaining water is only 56, 61 minus 5. So if you are putting the two number of the recharge wells, it becomes 10 cubic meter, and then almost it is going to be 51 cubic meter per hour water remained. and for that area simple volume calculation, length, width into depth of the recharge tank can be designed like this. So quantification here I have again put up it through the slide which I earlier explained about it. Now the diameter of the rainwater pipe, yes, it is very important. Earlier in the buildings, the old buildings, we find in urban area that all the buildings is covered by the rainwater pipe, means the rainwater pipe is running all the sites. It is not advisable nowadays, because if you see the concept of the green building, where the rainwater harvesting is mandatory or the important component apart from the other components in the green building, it is suggested that the new building should have only one side rainwater pipe. It reduces the cost of the rainwater pipe. Second, when we are going to construct or implement the technique of rainwater harvesting, we save the cost as well as the maintenance is very less. So construction of chambers are less. Therefore, we must nowadays have the slope of the roof one side, and which is nowadays being implemented in the concept of, on the line of the concept of the green building. And how we calculate the rainwater pipe dimension? A very simple formula, Q is equal to AV. We apply Q is equal to AV. A is the area to be known of the pipe, because we know the area is pi r square of any pipe because it is circular in nature. V is the entrance velocity of the water, which is taken the 1 meter per second. And Q, the volume or discharge or runoff which we are getting from the any roof water. So here we have taken the example in the case of rainfall is 600 mm per hour in any area, roof area is 500 square meter. Then simply we calculate the volume, and 90% of it we are taking the runoff coefficient as a means the loss of this water, and we get here 27 cubic meter per hour. As we are knowing that the diameter of the rainwater pipe is very important to be assessed, because if the diameter of the rainwater pipe is excess, the cost will be escalated. If the diameter of the rainwater pipe is less, then amount of runoff will not come down from the roof. That is also dangerous for the safety of the roof. Therefore, diameter of the rainwater pipe is very necessary to be calculated. And how we can calculate the diameter of the rainwater pipe? I have here explained very simply, taking the example of any roof area which is covering 500 square meter and rainfall intensity is 600 millimeter per hour. Then the volume we are getting here 30 cubic meter per hour, then 90% of it, because we are taking here that 10% is lost, that is 27 cubic meter per hour. And when we are getting this runoff with the simple application of this formula Q is equal to AV, where A is the area, V is the area of the pipe, and from this area, once area is calculated of the pipe, very simply putting the pi r square, we can know the radius of the pipe, and ultimately we can reach to the diameter of the pipe. So A is the area, V is the entrance velocity of the water, that is taken in 1 meter per second, and then the Q is the runoff or the discharge from the roof top area as a runoff. So earlier I have mentioned that 27 cubic meter per hour is the total runoff from generated from the 500 square meter roof area, and here we are applying this A becomes Q upon V. So Q is 27 cubic meter per hour, because we must have the same unit under the any calculation. So here we are mentioning here the 1 meter per second we are changing into the meter per hour, because intensity is taken as millimeter per hour. So here the if the intensity is also in meter per hour, then here the velocity, entrance velocity is also converted from 1 meter per second to 3600 meter per hour. And with the simple calculation, 27 upon 3600, it is coming 0.007 square meter. This is the area. And very simply, area is equal to pi r square. Then we are knowing here the r, and we are getting the R 0.45, and we are putting the diameter is the 2R, then we are getting the diameter of the rainwater pipe. So the designed diagrammatically here I am trying to emphasize how the recharge well is constructed and what is the diagram of the recharge well inside the recharge tank. Here the top figure in this diagram is the plan view, where one recharge well is shown, one is the filter chamber and one is the desilting chamber. Then after on the bottom, the diagram say reflects that it is one recharge well with the filter chamber and the inside the recharge tank. So it is suitable for 100 square meter to 400 square meter area, where the one recharge well is sufficient, where the rainfall intensity is 25 millimeter to 35 millimeter per hour. Suppose that we are taking the example of different cities in the UP, particularly Varanasi, Allahabad, Kanpur, Lucknow. Here we are considering the rainfall intensity 25 to 35 millimeter per hour, average rainfall intensity. Why we are speaking or talking or discussing about the average rainfall intensity? Because if we consider the peak rainfall intensity and make the design, that structure will be superfluous. That over design will be there. So that will be more costly. So therefore, we must have the model rainfall intensity, and that is taken into the quantification to calculate the per hour runoff, and then that is applied for the proper design. This is the another diagram how we construct the recharge well inside the recharge tank. Here in this diagram, it is very clear there are two recharge wells which are constructed earlier than any recharge tank. Because if we construct the recharge tank first and recharge well later on, then we cannot estimate the intake capacity of the recharge well, number one. Number two, drilling rig cannot reach to construct these recharge wells. So therefore, it is very important and caution must be taken that recharge well is constructed first, then followed by the recharge tank. So the recharge well is constructed by the simple drilling rig, and our depth is, in this particular diagram, the depth is 40 meter, and this is the case study of the Allahabad, where we have attempted this rooftop rainwater harvesting at Vikas Bhavan. The roof area is 1400 square meter, and after the calculating the entire runoff, we have made the design where two recharge wells are there of the 6 inch diameter, and the depth I have already mentioned, it is 40 meter, and the zones which have been tapped are the, you can say, the screen which is been placed inside the recharge well, that is of the 6 meter. And if you see the terminal part, or you can say the behind this recharge wells, that is the filter chamber where the man is standing, and behind that, that is the filter chamber, and that wall is known as containing weave holes, and that is the wall which is containing weave holes. Through these weave holes, the entire water after proper filtration, it is coming inside the recharge tank where these two recharge wells are there. And here with this diagram, it is very clear that how the entire runoff is coming to the recharge filter chamber, where you are finding that entire layer of three layers of the filter, pebble, gravel and sand, are separated by using the nylon mesh. Why we are using the nylon mesh? Because there are two benefits for application of this nylon mesh. One is intermixing is avoided. As you know that if the rainwater is coming into this filter chamber, certainly it will have its own velocity. It will be in the agitating mode. So it will disturb the proper arrangement of the pebbles, gravel and sand. So if you are putting the nylon mesh in between each layer, then it will avoid the mixing, number one. Number two benefit is during the peak summer season, when the monsoon is off, or during the even winter season, you can clean this filter material. by taking out all the filter material through help of this nylon mesh. And you can screen the dirty material or the unwanted material of this filter material, as well as you can clean entire filter material and you could place again the same, so it avoid the cost, and on the other hand it increases the efficiency of the filter. Then you are finding in this diagram the right side of the filter that there is a valve which is containing V hole. After proper filtration, the water comes into this recharge tank, and the water is being recharged through these two recharge wells through the screen. So it is very important to know or to adopt the screen on the top also. It is very clear from the diagram that in the recharge tank, here you are finding there is an air vent. After the air vent from the top, screens are there, because through the screens the water should be poured down or it should recharge the aquifer. And on the bottom there is a screen which is placed to move down the water into the aquifer system. So therefore, where to put this screen at the bottom? What should be the criteria? Criteria is simple. Criteria should be granular zone. And I have already explained in the beginning, when I was discussing about the scope of groundwater recharge, I mentioned categorically that we must take the help of strata chart, where we find the granular zones, depth of the granular zones, which varies in time and space. So therefore, we must put this screen at the proper place, and it should coincide at the depth of the granular zones below the ground surface. So the depth of this recharge well should also never coincide with the depth of the running tube well for the drinking purpose. It is also important. So we should restrict the depth of the recharge well up to the first aquifer, first granular zones, because in general we are using the groundwater, extracting the rather groundwater from the second or third aquifer system in entire country, because nowadays the subsurface groundwater at the shallow depth is contaminated, as well as the quantity is also very less, not going to be sustained. So therefore, in that depth range, we can put the recharge wells. The second technique is recharge shaft, because the recharge well is not helpful. Recharge well is not helpful for the open park or the forest area or open land area. There is a very clear cut reason that during the rainy season in the open land area or the green area, we get the maximum siltation in the runoff, and if it chokes the recharge well, therefore we must construct the recharge shaft in the open or the green area. It is very simple structure, large diameter dugwell structure, where we are diverting the runoff from the any building as well as the open park area nearby or the lawn, so that entire water is arrested and it is poured down into the recharge shaft. So it is made up of the simple a dugwell recharge type structure, and machinery structure is given as support from the top up to the 3 meter by bricks, so that from the top the part of this dugwell or the part of this recharge shaft does not collapse inside. So that machinery structure is there, otherwise it is totally behave like the open well structure. And there is a air vent pipe which is necessary for emission of the air, otherwise entering of the runoff into the recharge shaft will be sluggish. So therefore, it is very important to have or rather place this plastic PVC pipe, so that air choke condition is avoided. And on the bottom, here it is very clear from the diagram, right side, it is showing the composition of the filter, the same natural filter on the bottom, composed of boulders, pebbles, gravels and coarse sand. In place of, if you are not getting the pebbles, which is a common problem in the city, we are getting the sand, we are getting the even gravel known as bajri in the common word or layman, but we are not having the pebbles in the market. So we can use here the brick bats as well as the even bats of, or you can say the broken parts of the core also. So we should not worry if the pebbles are not available. Here we can use the brick bats, fragments of the bricks. Then the next is recharge shaft inside the drain, storm drain. Earlier recharge shaft is different with this. Earlier recharge shaft was like a dugwell, but here it is a structure which is constructed in the storm drains, constructed in the urban areas or rural areas. The requirement is that, or you can say the limitation is that, the storm drain should be constructed by either by bricks or by the concrete. Inside that storm drains, such structures can be placed. And in that structure, we are finding here that it is a very simple structure. On the top, 1 meter, it is rectangular, and then bottom, rest of the structure is a vertical and like a recharge well. But it is a simple, you can say, the open hole, and we are giving the support on the top up to 1 meter by the bricks, and we are filling all these excavated material and the structure with the gravels. All these structures is filled only with the gravels, and we are putting the air vent. As already I have mentioned that there must be air vent pipe, because air vent pipe avoids the air choking, and gravel is placed, it increases the permeability. So after, and it acts as a filter material. So after proper filtration, the entire runoff is recharged to the groundwater. This is also simple recharge well, and we are finding the put here the difference from the earlier recharge well and into this recharge well is that here we are using the Johnson screen, B-wire Johnson screen, and the diameter I have given here 8 meter, that is insignificant diameter, may be 6 inch, 4 inch, 10 inch, depending upon the total runoff. But the most important thing in the B-wire Johnson screen is that it is applied in the silty area, while the normal MS pipe screen not utilized, and rather should not be utilized in the silty area. Because if the suppose that in any area silt formation is there, or silty layer is there up to 30 meter, 40 meter, and we are bound to construct the recharge well, then we must use here the B-wire Johnson screen, so that the intake capacity of the B-wire Johnson screen is more efficient than the normal MS mild steel pipe screen. The next technique, that is the dugwell recharge technique, which has been implemented in Bundelkhand at the MOS level and supported by the government of India as well as the government of UP in the Uttar Pradesh. And we are finding from the diagram that this dugwell recharge is very simple technique, and which is also boon for the entire Bundelkhand region, particularly for the farmers. As we are knowing that the farmers are depending upon the dugwell for irrigation during the peak hours for the irrigation for sustaining their crops. Therefore, to make the water level sustainable of these dugwells, which are existing in the agricultural field of the farmers, is very important. So therefore, such technique has been implemented, and in this diagram it is very clear that from the left side there is a desilting chamber, then followed by the filter chamber. Again, this filter chamber is characterized by the filter material, same filter materials as a natural filter, composed of the pebbles, gravels and sand. After this filtration, entire runoff is diverted into the dugwell, existing dugwell for agriculture field of the farmer. So entire runoff generated from the agriculture area is poured down to this dugwell, which is sustaining the water level of this dugwell, and which is quite useful, or you can say the needed during the peak hours for during the irrigation purpose. Therefore, it is very important to understand that the mass applicability of this ductwell recharge in the entire Bundelkhand region, either the part of UP or MP, is acceptable by the society, particularly by the farmers. There are two reasons for this acceptability. One is it is low cost technique. Second is the upkeep is very minimum, very less. Third is there is no complex engineering design in this structure. Therefore, farmers are able to maintain it, to understand this technique, and they have adopted such techniques at the mass scale, which has been supported by the government of India financially. And in the future also, we are going to observe that such structures, such techniques are implemented in another hard rock area in the different states of our country, which is very beneficial for sustaining the groundwater resource for future generation. Then this is also a very simple structure. This structure or technique can be shifted from place to place by the requirement of the local people. Gabion structures, the simple runoff is generated from the higher reaches. The limitation of this structure is that the width of this stream should be very less. Less means 2 to 3 meters, not beyond that. And the catchment area should be also limited to the 50 to 100 square meter, because if you are finding that, or you are observing in this diagram, downstream side, we are putting here the boulder in the wire mesh, chicken wire mesh, and entire runoff is tried to be arrested here, but certain runoff goes down stream side also. So our aim to implement this technique is that the rate of runoff is going to be deaccelerated, arrested by putting such structures, so that in and around the area, groundwater level is sustained, the decline in the groundwater level or depletion in the groundwater level is arrested, and the source of the water also available simultaneously in this stream, either for irrigation or any their day-to-day need. So these type of the common techniques I have tried to explain, which are going to be a very successful techniques, either implemented in the urban area or the rural area. Secondly, I want to emphasize that technique is site specific. It is not necessary that whatever I have explained the techniques, one technique is suitable for entire area, entire country. Therefore, in even one district, even one block, from village to village, from location to location, the techniques, or even you can say the part of techniques. Thank you very much for having the patience, and have a nice time. We'll be right back.